So, in the combined modality arm, 11% patients had could not get the 63 grays planned for them, and doses had to be reduced for them. In the chemotherapy, 51% patients only could get 3 cycles of the 3 cycles planned for them. 38% could get 2 cycles, 4% could get 1 cycle, and 6% couldn't get any cycle of chemotherapy. Acute mucosal reactions were comparable in both the arms. Hematological toxicities were more in the combined modality arm as compared to the continuous radiation arm. Also, the percentage weight loss was more in the combined modality arm as compared to the continuous radiation arm. The local regional control was seen somewhat better in the combined modality arm as compared to continuous radiation arm, but it was not found to be statistically significant. Also, the overall survival was same in both the arms. The metastasis-free survival was again better in the combined modality arm, but was not statistically significant. The only statistical significance found in this study was the locoregional control in the oropharyngeal region, where combined modality treatment showed better local control as compared to the continuous irradiation arm. There was again no statistical significance based on the risk groups. Also, there were no apparent differences between the late toxicities in between both arms. So, to conclude, while the conclusion from this study is limited due to the premature closure, concurrent postoperative chemo-RT tended to improve locoregional control as compared to continuous irradiation arm. The overall survival did not differ between the two arms, but postoperative chemo-RT was associated with a substantial increase in hematological toxicities that affected radiotherapy and chemotherapy compliance in this arm.